Hello everyone, Trix here, and welcome to Donkey Kong 94 Part 3 Remake of Donkey Kong, even though it doesn't feel like a remake at all, because this game is so much more than what the original game was. Right, in all honesty, I have been playing this game on a certain setting. You might have noticed this, because of me wanting to play this on the Super Game Boy. And me wanting to actually make this look as smooth as possible. I'm the kind of guy who for some reason always wants my videos to be as widescreen as possible. However, in a Game Boy game like this, it does not always work out too well. It becomes really blocky if you do it like that. And I therefore have introduced a little shader effect in order to blur out the blockiness of the pixels a little bit. But I'm not too sure if I actually like it all that much, in all honesty, so I might change that in the future. Right now I'm going to say I'll just keep it at this. But it might be the case that I'm going to change it back. I did already change it back after part 2 to make it look like what it originally would look like with the blocky 8-bit pixels. But I didn't really like that too much either, so I think I'm going to stay with this for a while, unless I can find a better shader. This is actually a shader that I introduced in a game that I'm going to play later. It really bothered me with the way it looked like, even up to the fact that I decided I'm going to play that from an emulator just like this one. Because I was going to play it on the Wii U first, but I didn't like the way it looked actually. But the SNES graphics being ported to a newer modern system through HDMI cable, in all honesty, does not always look too well. And therefore, I thought if I play this on emulator, I'm excused to do so because I have the game on my own twice even. But still. I thought you were going to run. Apparently, they first start looking around. Yeah, these guys actually start running around if they hear you. They have these big ears, as you can see. And if they hear you, like this guy does, as you can see, you first look around and then they start chasing you high speed. You can still jump over them, so do so. This hammer can make sure short work out of them. Like everything, hammer is obviously the best power-up in the game, so nothing scares the hammer. They don't run off edges. Okay, nice to know. Grab the purse. Grab the key. High key. No, jump down. Oh, I wanted to fall on top of the key. Really, you're going to stay there. Go around again. Enemies, I don't like you. Come on, I challenge you. Bam! Let's forget about the 1-up. I'm dying a crap load of times and still I have 48 lives, so I have decided not to need the 1-ups when they are too tricky to get. As long as I get my bonus, I am satisfied. 2-up, coming up. There's no way that line of 3 2-ups wasn't going to be picked. Right, level 211. Yeah, these worlds can get quite long. There's a lot of stages in some of these. World 0 was 4, world 1 was 8, and now world 2 is 12? Oh my! So much platforming to do. Let's see. I think we need to go all the way up from here. And then work our way down with the key. The challenge in this level, of course, being the fact that you are probably thinking, I can just drop down all the way, then I'm at the door immediately. But you need to remember, fall damage, my friends. you do that, you are dead. So you need to take this one floor at a time. There we go. Yeah, not ashamed to admit it. The very first time I did the stage, I clearly remember. I did try to fall down all the way immediately. For some reason, I have platforming in my head, the regular platforming, the regular Mario platforming, and I, even in this game, even though I know I die from high falls in this game, I sometimes still forget that. Nowadays, that's not really too much of an issue. I can remember not to do things like that. That was clearly not always the case. Right, the second boss fight with DK. Once again, throw the barrels and completely miss them. Gimmick this time, use the trampolines to get up to his height. And then it's simply a simple matter of throwing once you get a chance. And of course, you can miss, so... Ooh, he blocked it. Epic block by DK. Oh, and remember, whenever two barrels collide, like you saw with DK himself throwing one, but also the regular rolling ones, they will get nullified, both of them. Barrel versus barrel ends in a draw. It would be nice if I start dying a little less. Even though I'm pretty well aware of why it is happening, I have not played this game for so long and I'm still getting used to controls a little bit. Thank you for that, by the way. And new mechanic. Accidentally got introduced. Apparently, if you get knocked back because of you holding another item and getting hit by something, the getting thrown back gets nullified by the trampoline, apparently. Because as you may have seen, I got hit by that barrel, but I did not fall all the way. I hit the trampoline and that cancelled it out. I did not know it worked like that, actually. Good to know. Right, and with that, level 2 is done. New mechanic. Sideways ropes, which you can use to jump like this. We've already seen the horizontal ones, which you can use to jump up higher. But now they get placed sideways. Right, 12 stages done. Level 2 done. Oh, the blinking, my capture card's not going to like again. And we get to the ship. 8 levels this time again. It's not going to be 12 every single time from now on. World 3. The ship. Yeah, Pauline. I know. I want to help you. The DK is not going to make it so easy like the first time we did this. Even though this is technically the same time we're doing this. Because this is not the successor to DK. It's not like Donkey Kong just tries again to kidnap Pauline. No, it's the very same time. Only this time the story is a little bit more expanded. Right, what we want to do here is place a bridge here so the block dude can go to the spike pit over there. That's where we want him. So we can get to the key. One up down there, by the way. You can jump in the water here. To get the hat and the key. The hat and the one up. I don't think I'm going to bother. It takes a little bit too long, I think. And you can clearly see what you need to do, so I'm just gonna go for a higher score, which is more seconds remaining. That's kind of the trade-off you can do in these games. You can decide, I'm going to go for all the bonuses and therefore get one-up chance whenever the level is done. Or you can say, no, I am not going to do that. I am going to play this level fast, quote-unquote speedrun it, so I can get higher bonuses through my time remaining, and therefore at the end of the world giving me more bonus. And it's mostly that reason that I do not really consider getting all of the objects in a level part of the 100%, actually, because there are two ways in which you can decide to maximize the scoring in your levels. You can say, I'm going to go for the objects, and therefore bonus chance at the end of the level, or you can say, I'm going to go for fast time, and therefore bonus chance at the end of the world. That's a little trade-off you can do. Would be nice if you just moved aside. The guy doesn't like moving too much. He doesn't really have to. This is where I wanted to be, but I wanted to go here safely. Not with that guy pinching me. Yeah, because of these reasons, you might see me grab all of the items a little bit less. They're not really required, they're just there to give you extra lives. But there are more ways to get extra life than just that. And with most of these, they are not really too hard to get, so I'm not going to use this Let's Play as a walkthrough of how to get these things. They're pretty obvious every single time, actually, so because of that, I might not always bother, unless they're really easy to get. Right, we get introduced to something else here, this black block over here. It works like the ladder we have seen a couple of times, or the expandable platforms. But these ones work like this. Same deal, same timer, only this time it's just a single block. There's no entire ladder appearing or entire platform that expands from left to right. This is just a single block. And we have four locked doors. This is another mechanic that gets introduced here. As you can clearly see. More than one locked door. Only one of them is real. You may have seen me trying to do those two on the right. Nothing happened. Those were fakes. It's not like you have multiple ways to exit the level this way. There's still only one exit. But there's also fake doors. Not going to bother with the one-up. I'm just going to continue the level. Grab the key. Throw the key. Throw yourself. Get up here. Too high to jump yourself, so use this trick. No, this is the real one, apparently. That's how it works. One real door in any level. Whenever multiple doors appear, you need to find out which one the real one is. Usually not that hard. They are usually not that far apart like this one. I stupidly assumed the furthest ones were going to have the real door. That's what I would have done if I programmed this. This is where things get annoying. DK actually has a switch now, which he uses to change conveyor belts or change doors. So pay close attention to when he starts using the switch and try to screw with you. Right now the door opens over there. There's multiple switches for yourself to use as well. I did not want to go there. I just tried to lure that guy into falling. And yeah, I was pretty well aware that was a conveyor belt, so I was going to go left quicker. And yet, it still killed me. Man, this level scares me. Really, I can't jump that. Right, I'll do it like this. Don't! I was afraid he was going to do that. D- Don't let anyone try to tell you this game is easy. It is not easy. I did not want to fall off. Man, the controls are killing me now. I can't really blame the enemies and the mechanics too much right now. I know what is happening. It's just me not really getting used to the mechanics quite yet that is tripping me up. That's usually not a bad thing. That's usually something that resolves itself after a while. After I've played this enough times. That's what I tried to do last time. Would be nice if it actually let me. Right. Open you. Come on, hurry up. DK. Open the door. Yeah, you need to jump if you're going to against the direction of a conveyor belt. That would have been nice to know earlier. I was a little bit curious about what that other switch up top did. I should have checked that in the first place. That actually puts a bridge between those thwomps. Let's call them thwomps. To go from you, I see. You know, I could just ride you up now. Couldn't do that earlier, but now there's actually a door open, so I actually have a way to finish the level so like this. Yeah, this was actually an example of a level being a little bit more tricky. But not undoable. Ooh, it was almost out of time, I see. 37 seconds was not that many. Still give me 5 up. Even though I died a couple of times in this level, I still gain lives. I was at 57 and now I'm going to go up to 61. So. Yeah, this level is not really easy as you may see level-wise, but it does not mean that it's impossible to do. The level is pretty generous when the game is pretty generous when it comes to handing out 1-ups. Even though I have been dying quite a lot. Good thing, actually. Don't want this to be too easy for me, now wouldn't we? But still. I'm still gaining lives left and right, mostly right, because lives are displayed on the right. Oh, I'm trying to be funny, and I fail at it every single time. Bam! Come on, spin! And whoop! Right, I have no idea what you are for, maybe to kill some of the enemies. Right now, I don't consider that necessary. The key is over here. Oh, there's enemies in the trash bins now. Which start walking when you start walking on top of them. Alright, let's see where you go, my friend. Nothing further up top here, so I'm going to assume we need to go down again. Ah, there we are. That's why I didn't register where the door was, because it was in such an obvious spot, I simply looked over it. But I assumed it was at the bottom, because I clearly saw it was not at the top, so. Really liking these Mario faces, huh? Let's see if I can get a second one. Nope. One up. Alright. We're moving closer and closer to the top of the ship, where the end of the world is. We have a couple of these mobile platforms with us. Let's call them the mobile platforms. These things need to have a name at some point. Even though they probably do have their official name, I just don't know it myself. Let's see if we can cheese this part. If we place you like this... That does not work. Oh, of course, the platforms cannot go through solid or non-solid blocks like these lined out objects themselves. They actually stop. As you can see, whenever you try to place these blocks on top of where something else should be, like this, even if it's lined out, this block over here, even when it's lined out and therefore means it is in use and things like this, the platforms cannot go through that. Right, now the solution to this puzzle becomes more clear. We need a platform over there so the enemies go out of the way, which are impossible to avoid otherwise. And then place you over here so we can actually get to the next part. It might become a little bit more tricky now and then, but the solutions are never too far away. Alright. Let's finish this. And therefore, this part, because 21 minutes. And that means we are done. I don't think that's for 3 up. Nope. Not even 2 up. Right, we're getting closer to the end of World 3, and therefore the next boss fight. But for now, this is it. Next time we will continue with World 3, finish World 3, and get started with the 4th world, where things get upped a little bit more in difficulty, even more. Because, of course, the further we get, the harder it gets. And even this is already tripping me up a little bit here and there. I'm liking that. Some of these Let's Plays have been way too easy for me. I've been gaming way too long. I'm getting way too good at this. Sometimes it's a little bit more fun to fail. What am I saying? I have 63 lives. What is failing here? Thanks for watching. Treeks out.